Should have recorded the last one. All right, we are doing some personal packs here tonight. It's 11 o'clock on Thursday night. Jerry just did a pack, and he's buying another personal pack. Here's what he had in his first pack. He hit a Joey Bart, who is a top prospect. So, Joey Bart, and that was a prism. He also hit Patrick Bailey autograph. He was a first rounder from Stanford. Hit that autograph, prism. Baron Radcliffe from Georgia Tech, he hit. That was also a prism. Then, here's Jordan Mickle. He's the White Sox guy. Owen Cassie, Casey Martin, top prospect, and Cade Meckles. So that was his first bag, or first pack, and this was in the first pack as well. How about this for his first pack? Asa Lacy. Gold prism to 50. Jerry has the luck of the Irish. Gold prism to 50 of a top 10 draft pick. So now he is doing another pack because he can't stop after hitting an Asa Lacy. So here we go with pack number 3 for Jerry. Remember, there's an auto in every one of these packs. And there's 5 prisms, 5 autos, and 5 numbered parallels in every box. So on average, oh my gosh. I just looked at who's on top. So on average, you'll definitely get one autograph, and you should get 3 other hits in every pack. So 4 out of 8 cards should be hits, and that's the way it was in that last one. And here's our first card out of the second pack. How about some Pete Crow Armstrong action? Jerry, you can add that to your Pete Crow collection. Oh my. That is a nice hit. Not a prism or anything, but that's still a nice hit of a gonna be superstar player. So he deserves a sleeve even though he's not considered a hit in this. And C.J. Van Eek from Stanford. I think he was a top prospect. Yeah, no, I know. I saw that today, Jerry. I am, like, getting very worried. Serving as a starter and reliever, Van Eek total made 19 appearances, 7-0 with a 2.6 ERA, 71 strikeouts. Most from a Florida State pitcher since Lynch went 12-0. So, another big prospect. Oh, a nice, here we go, a power surge, Alaric Solare, power surge numbered to 50, maybe? Is this orange? It is nice, whatever it is. Are these numbered? It is a prism. Prism power surge. Solari topped the Tennessee charts in home runs while ranking second in RBIs. Oh, okay. My hitting is my biggest strength. I can hit for contact, power, and average. I can use all parts of the field. Well, that is nice. And that is a prism for you. And that is a top loader also for you. And do we want to look at the auto or do we want to go to the others? I don't know if this is the auto or not, but it may be a dual auto if it's an auto. What is this? Dual auto! Oh, dude! Hudson Haskin and Cody Hose! Cody Hose! OMG! Oh my, oh my, oh my, Cody Hose! Oh, let me get that in a sleeve and a top loader, like, right now. Dude, you're killing it! Oh, man, oh, man, oh, man. Oh, dude. Oh, man, oh, man, oh, man. You are doing it up, living clean, Jerry. That's like clean living does to you. Gives you cards like that. Oh, my goodness. I haven't even checked to see if it's numbered yet. Look at that. All right, not numbered, but who cares? Cody Hose and Haskin Auto. Wow. Congrats, Jerry. Couldn't happen to a better guy, my friend. Oh my goodness, that was a nice hit. Let's see who else we got. Jackson Miller. This is sexy. This is that blue. What are blues to 100 or 99? Oh, it's just a regular blue prism. Okay. All right, Jackson Miller. What's it say about Miller? Blue Mojo. Okay. Yeah. Didn't exactly write up a glowing review on him. But he still gets a top loader. All right, next up. Oh my gosh, would you give me a break, Jerry? Please, would you? How about Zach Veen? OMG. Zach Veen, oh my goodness. Numbered to 15, are you serious? Oh my God. Oh my Lord, have mercy. Ever so gently with Mr. Veen. To 15. Can you believe those two are in the same pack? You hit a Zach Veen and a Cody Hose and somebody else dual auto in the same pack. Holy shnikes. OMG. When Colorado tabbed Veen in the opening round of the 2020 draft, he already had a mentor on the team, Brendan Rodgers. That's a good guy to have as a mentor. How cool is that? All right, next up. We still got more cards coming. All right, we got Justin Levy. Who is this guy? Louisville. A Louisville Cardinal here. Justin Levy. Ended his four-year run in a 12-game hitting streak. Three RBI against Valpo. Solo homer against the Chicago State. Hits keep coming to next level. Cardinals senior second baseman signed a free agent deal with Seattle in June. All right, last card is a fireworks prism of Gus Steiger. What does it say about Gus? Originally a second baseman, transitioned to short. He looked like an old pro within a year. South Dakota State, an average hits, runs, stolen bases. Keystone star, didn't commit an error in 53 total chances at the sixth post. So there's a future shortstop in the majors. Wow, 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 Jerry. Holy smoke. Let's just do a quick recap of your two packs, because it's unbelievable. All right. Are you going to do one more pack? one. I'm going to pick pack one for you. All right, here's pack number one. I saw your one up there as soon as I looked up, so I'm going with that. If you get another one, you'll leave one for Rod's. Going to be mad he didn't get to get his cards, and he waited till tomorrow night. Wait till he sees this video. All right, pack one for Rod. Here we go, Rod, for Jerry. All right, Jerry, pack one. I don't know. We can't get any better, can we? Holy smoke, dude. Well, I guess we can keep rolling along, though. Max Mayer, top prospect. Max Mayer. Top 20, I think. Capping off a strong three-start stretch, registered 15 whiffs, first Golden Gopher to do it. Iranians, Utah, his previous parents. Well, he's a top prospect. They didn't. I think he's top. Top five? Yeah, if I remember right. They didn't, like, give him much of a write-up for being, like, top five. It's like, what kind of write-up is that for this guy? I'm even giving him his own top loader. All right, how about Kyle Nicholas for somebody's Cardinal? Who is that? Something State. South North Carolina? Or South Carolina State? I don't know. Let's see if it tells us. All right. Mowing them down. Oh, Ball State. Nicholas allowed one hit over and struck out nine. It was one of his many fine performances through the right-hander's career. 17 whiff outing with his Sacred Heart. See, some of these are like pretty blah write-ups about somebody. All right, here we go. How about Nick York? Nick York. Is that a circle prism of some sort? I just had something in there. It's a prism. That's a cool looking prism. All right. Oh, he's Boston. Shades of former Kevin Youkilis. We think he's going to get the power. That'll work. Nice prism there. See him for the Red Sox in a while. All right, let's go to your auto. All right, Casey Schmidt. No clue. Maybe you can enlighten me. Casey Schmidt. Don't remember that name in the first round, I don't think. Maybe he's a second rounder. That is a prism. See what it says about him. Oh, Giants? Second round. Oh, okay. Well, I should have known that name then. Or at least been familiar with it. Casey Schmidt. All right. Nothing wrong with that. Second rounder. Heck yeah. Nick York, Boston's number one pick. You're getting some sweet stuff. Oh, my goodness. This is gorgeous. I don't know what it's worth. But I don't know who Werner Blakely is, but that's a pretty cool prism there. Was that Red Mojo? Angels, huh? Werner Blakely. Detroit isn't necessarily known as a hotbed for baseball talent. In fact, he was taken in a fourth round of the draft. Became the highest drafted high school player out of Motown since Mark Washington. Determined to start a new trend. Well, let's hope so, Mr. Blakely. You got a nice stack going already over here. Who is this? Ian Bedell, Missouri Tigers. Missouri Tiger. Out of 99, nice red. That's red? It looks orange to me. That's orange, right? Oh, Tiger Stripe? Oh, sweet. You have opened a ton of these. Out of 99, little did he know at the time, start wishing I would be his last at Missouri. Went out with a bang. 3 months later, drafted by St. Louis. Staying in the home area there. Cool. Numbered to 99 Tiger Stripe. I like that. Missouri Tigers, too. Isn't that cool? He's a Missouri Tiger with Tiger Stripe Prism. Oops, I grabbed the wrong one. There you go, buddy. Get in there. Enjoy yourself with all the other stars. Dylan McClain. Dylan McClain. Pitching prospect can throw hard and have excellent height and length, but if he can't throw strikes, there's not much hope for a future. He McClain's all the necessary traits. Pounded a strike on like a hammer to a nail with Central Catholic High School in Portland, Oregon. There's a long shot. Oh, Thunderstruck. Joey Weeman, or Weimer. I think he's a first or second round. I recognize that name. Where'd he go? Joey Weimer. Gonna do pack four? All right. University of Cincinnati. Joey Weimer. Nice insert. It's hardly an area in which Weimer didn't excel at Bedford, where he played. Maintaining, you know, good times kept rolling. Cincinnati. 119 career hits. ACC. Brewers, what round? All right, we're going to be doing pack four here as well for Jerry, which would leave pack five for Rod tomorrow night. So you chose Rod's fate unless someone else takes pack five. This is pack four for Jerry. Here we go, Jerry. Good luck, my friend. You are killing it. Pack three was just okay, man. Pack one and two, you tore it up. All right, starting out with Trevor Hauver from somewhere. Arizona State? That's not Arizona State. It'd be interesting to see what that is. Pitchers tended to avoid pitching to the number one overall pick, Torkelson. When they gave him a free pass to first, Hauver made him pay. All right. The sweet singing junior finished the 20K at 339. Oh, my. Oh, yeah. Yankees? He could tear it up, huh? So he batted behind Torkelson. Oh, that's a nice hit. That'll work. Oh, here we go. Ian Seymour from Virginia Tech Hokies. Well, one good thing, we're not going to have to deal with this focus issue after Friday. Ian Seymour, Virginia Tech Hokie. 57th overall selection in a 2020 draft. Seymour became the highest drafted Virginia Tech player since Joe Saunders. Marked the first time two Hokies were selected in the first round as catcher Carson Tyler was picked in the fourth frame. 57th overall. Second rounder. That is, so you must just have good stuff coming up. Anthony Servideo, Prism, Mississippi. Servideo, see, oh yeah, this is the guy from the none list, you're right. Ole Miss did whatever it could to keep Servideo's potent bat in the lineup. In his final season, he hit 390 with career-high 5 home runs and finished second in the nation with 24 walks. Well, he seems to deserve better not getting drafted. So who's he playing for? Is he still not signed with anybody, I guess? Or did you say he got signed? Uh-oh, here you go. You got a good one. Good auto. Matt Manning. And it's the orange version, I guess. It looks chrome, or it looks copper to me, but orange, or that's gold. Okay, yeah. Oh, my gosh. Number to 10, Jerry? Oh, I thought it was the orange to 50 or whatever it was. Oh, my gosh, Jerry. All right, what's Matt Manning at? As I recognize his name. 6'6 is a lot for hitters to take in and may not be done growing. Double A Erie. All right, my hometown. So Erie, I think, is, yeah, Detroit. Tigers to 10. Oh, my. Where did he get picked? He was a first rounder, right, Matt Manning? Number to 10. Oh, my gosh. Wow, that is amazing. Jerry, you killed it in those four packs. And we're not done yet. Oh, but not last draft? Okay. Wow. All right, here we go. Next up, Mason Hickman with the red. Red Prism. Hickman. What do we got to say about Hickman here? One of the best dependable and reliant pitchers in Vanderbilt history. 19-2. Clinched the national championship. Huh. Mason Hickman, Vanderbilt. Vanderbilt produces some top players. And we got a fireworks. Check this out of Austin Martin. Oh, doggy doggies. Austin Martin for the Commodores. Oh, that is sweet. Jerry, you are killing it. Over and over and over. What is that? 25 of 35? 29 of 35. And he's definitely a top 10 draft pick. Austin Martin. Holy smoke. Check that out. That is way, way cool. Camera doesn't give this thing justice. This thing is just like Sparkle City. That is gorgeous. All right, what's it say about Austin Martin? Hopefully they write him up good. Likened him to a welterweight champ. He's always coming. Austin Martin, sweetness. All right, Shane Drouin. San Francisco? Springfield? I have no idea. Shane Drouin. Many times you'll see pitchers skip over the foul line or draw initials in the dirt on the mound. Drouin is an exception. I kind of see it as just like fear. If you don't have your lucky socks on, you can't perform, he said. I don't have any of that. This dude doesn't need luck. All right, here is the last hit. I guess we got all your hits out at the beginning of the pack. Tanner Murray. Tanner Murray. All right, what's it say about Tanner Murray here? They say baseball season more marathon than a sprint. Nuri knows all about marathons. He played in a 24-inning epic. Not only a tie school record, he also winning rare. I am going to... I'll come up with a figure. If you want it, I'll come up with one. I'll give you my normal price. All right, pack five. So Rod's gonna get a fresh box. Rod, I think you... Oh man, I don't know. This is one heck of a box. Oh my goodness. This box has been amazing. So, I don't know. Oh my gosh. Well, let's go with Mick Abel. Mick Abel. Prism. Oh, no prism. Just, but it is Mick Abel. Mick Abel is definitely top loader worthy. All right, Alex Santos. Not sure Alex Santos. There are at least a couple of Houston fans in the Bronx. Santos is the reason, the standout from Mount St. Michael's. Houston Astros, second round draft pick. Features three solid pitches and the build to become an ace. Nice hit there, too. All right, Tyler Keenan. Just a base prism. Of all the big league players to emerge from Mississippi, he is the all-time leader in home runs. Holy cow. It's a mark in serious jeopardy now with Keenan entering the fray. Huh. Guy can hit, apparently. And he gets a top loader for being a prism. Oh, I think this is a good guy to have. I'm not positive, though. Cole Henry. Cole Henry Auto, LSU. Why do I recognize... Oh, is he a dud? Oh, it's a prism. Cole Henry emerges the Tigers' top pitcher at LSU. That's saying a lot. Florida State. And then filled the role of ace again in 2020 before heading to Washington as a high selection. So he's playing for the Nationals and he was a top selection. I guess you just don't like him. Nationals. Yeah. Maybe he'll prove you wrong. All right. What fun stuff do we have here? Justin Lang. Blue prism. Stop me if you heard this before. Hard throwing pitcher from Texas drafted with a high selection. Dominated 90s fastball, power slider. San Diego, 34th overall pick. Yeah, obviously you want to get hitters. Pitchers are so underappreciated. Holy smoke. This guy, number 34 overall. Not bad position. Hey, you got a Tiger stripe coming. You're not going to believe this either. You are not going to believe this. How about Zach Veen, Tiger Stripe? This box was absolutely ridiculous. Zach Veen, wow. To 99. Yeah, Zine Asa Lacy. What was the other guy? Hose, Cody Hose. Joey Bart, I think you had. Zach Veen, man, oh man, oh man. All right, Jordan Walker, Power Surge. Pretty average box. Oh my gosh. St. Louis fans feel a charge of excitement thinking about the power pack career they're about to watch unfold. Walker 6'5". Oh, St. Louis is going to be loving life. Nice power surge. Insert, and we'll end it with Cantrell. Hey, not bad. Raging Cajun. Hayden Cantrell. No, right, yeah. Ask any coach, you list the pros, you better pull up a chair. He's an elite runner, he's a high-level defender, he's a switch hitter, the bat's there, it's just going to get better with time. All right, that was a fun box. That was a whole lot of fun. So let's do a quick recap of Jerry's world that we live in here. That's just a cool card. Tiger Stripe. Max Mirror. Here we go. I'd already pulled those out. All right. Here's all the amazing stuff out of box one. We had the Joey Bart. And I just like him. So we had Joey Bart, Prism, had a Patrick Bailey auto, Prism, Asa Lacy. That was a huge hit here. Asa Lacy to 50. Pete Crow Armstrong. This is awesome. How about this? Cody Hose and Hudson Haskin. Green Flakes? I don't know. Green Flakes. Maybe it was something in a box. I don't know. This was sweet. Dual auto. How about a Zach Veen? The Zach Veen Show. Number to 15. How about Zach Veen again? Oh, really? I didn't notice. I'll take a look. It might be the blue coming off the mat. Wearing the wear on the mat. It might be blue, not green. 99 to Zach Veen. A Cole Henry auto. Yeah, I need to get a new one. Mick Abel. Sweet. Austin Martin. This is an awesome card. Austin Martin. Fireworks. That was numbered 35. Matt Manning. That numbered to 10. Unbelievable. And Casey Schmidt. Auto. So that was the recap for the box. Jerry, love you, buddy. You are the man, and you have the luck of the Irish. If that's an average box, I can't wait to see the incredible boxes. All right, guys, that's it for the break. Thank you for watching, and we've got tons of this stuff. I'm trying to get another case to come in as well. So enjoy it while it's here, and I will see y'all next break.